it is not the DM. I see that every person is saying the DM did this, the DM did this, the DM said that, the DM said that. It is not the DM, but the CM who has done this. The DM is merely the symptom. The disease lies with the chief minister.
Well, Rahul, first of all, it is for the first time that one is being given to understand that an investigation is taking place where it is the victim's family that has been put in house arrest. Their phones have been snatched and all their phone records, etc. are being, looked into and their phones are being tapped. I think in all cases, this usually happens in a criminal justice system when the investigation kicks in with the accused and those who are complicit with the accused and not with the victims. And we are given to understand that media is not being permitted to reach out to the family or reach the house where the family lives. And the entire family has been put in house arrest, is being threatened, is being intimidated, is being repressed merely because they wish to conduct an independent, the so-called independent investigation. If you were to look, and you have said this on a number of occasions, if you were to look through the chronology of the events, you have the director of the information department saying that this is fake news, no rape ever happened. You have the SP saying that rape never happened, it was mere strangulation. You have the ADG of the police who says that the neck and the spinal cord of the victim was not broken. It is a hoax. You have no less than the DM walking into the house of the victim, threatening them, kicking the tayaji of the victim and saying that, look, media wallahs will go in a couple of days. You and I will still be around. So beware of what you say. And on top of it, you have the thanedar, the station house officer of the police station, who burns the body of the deceased in the dead of the night. This shows. And Rahul, coupled with the fact that your journalist's phone is being tapped, the victim's family phone is being tapped, brings me to three very clean, irrefutable, indisputable conclusions. Conclusion number one, while four men raped the daughter, Hathras daughter, India's daughter, it is the entire administration of Uttar Pradesh that has repeatedly gang raped physically, mentally and emotionally the entire family of the victim. Number two, there seems to be a complete breakdown of law and order. Law and order seems to be breakdown, and the way phones are being recorded, I have no hesitation in saying that there is a constitutional breakdown of machinery. There is a breakdown of constitutional machinery, and certainly the higher ups, the president, the honorable Supreme Court, must look into this matter and take suo motu cognizance. And lastly, it is not the DM. I see that every person is saying the DM did this, the DM did this, the DM said that, the DM said that. It is not the DM, but the CM who has done this. The DM is merely the symptom. The disease lies with the chief minister.
Mr. Malviya, you want to respond to this?